So NETosis is a process by which a type of white blood cell called a neutrophil spews its intracellular material, all the material that is inside the cell, including the DNA and some toxic substances, into the extracellular space. And by doing that, it can trap and kill microbes. But in patients with autoimmune diseases, this process goes awry, and the cells make form nets even in the absence of any infection. And because they externalize the material that should be inside the cell, and the cell dies during this process, this can lead to the activation of the immune system and organ damage. And we know that this happens particularly in patients with systemic lupus erythematosus. So mitochondria are the cell powerhouses, and they are very important in the metabolism of oxygen. And during this process, they generate byproducts that are called reactive oxygen species. And these are important to maintain the health of the cell, but they can also induce tissue damage and cell death. And in patients with autoimmune diseases, we have found that mitochondrial reactive oxygen species are increased. And this is a process that is involved in the enhanced net formation that the cells from lupus patients exhibit. And so we think that this is a significant mechanism that is leading to promoting inflammation in patients with lupus. So by identifying the mitochondria and NETs as important drivers of inflammation in lupus and other autoimmune diseases, we may be able to design novel therapeutics that will target these important pathways. And in fact, there are companies that are currently designing drugs that may target NETosis and the mitochondria and mitochondrial reactive oxygen species. And so we are hoping to be able to test them in diseases like lupus and other autoimmune processes and address whether we can decrease inflammation and prevent organ damage.